Welcome,
and we are indeed ready for the matchup between Texas Southern and Prairie View A&M. The big guys are at the middle part of the floor. The official will step in between, toss it skyward, and we'll get this one underway. And the opening tip controlled by Prairie View A&M. Hey, good. A guy who played some of his junior college ball in Georgia, Pensacola product, had it first over to Briscoe. Of course, you've got Trey Haygood, John Briscoe, Karim York, Montrell Scott, and Ragi Anwamukawache, who is on the floor to begin this one. That's for Prairie View A&M. Bucket counts. Scott immediately.
Yep, Montrell is giving giving Prairie View what they need. That's a score from the perimeter. Because Rim told me that they're going to try to speed the game up. He said he thinks that his team plays better when they're up-tempo and pressuring.
Chris Thomas, Medarius Gibbs, Malcolm Ryland, Tony Collier, Joshua Fryer. Those are the Tigers on the floor to begin this one. Gibbs.
And Prairie View is going to play this zone. The zone has been one of the only things that has slowed Texas Southern up this year. And you get a turnover off of the out of that zone, so they're being very active in their zone.
Collier bounced it off the official. Giovanni Mack, a 5'9", 175-pound freshman from Charlotte, North Carolina, quickly into the game for Texas Southern.
And Collier's been playing real steady for Texas Southern.
Briscoe's got it over to Haygood. And there was a push as Haygood brings it around to the left side. It is Mack that commits the foul. Non-shooting foul, Scott from the baseline. York off of the three. On Wukamuche getting the rebound, gives it to Briscoe. Four may be a little slick there near the left timeline as Briscoe went down to his palm but maintained the dribble. Haygood with a bounce pass. Briscoe in and out on the three. On Wukamuche almost brought it in. It looked like he had a little stick on those fingers.
He was really after that one. Texas Southern's coming. Prairie View's coming with this full court pressure. They're going to try to wear it. Did they get a steal out of it?
Briscoe to Haygood over Gibbs. Rolls from one side of the rim to the other and is yanked down by Collier.
Boy, they got to be able to capitalize when they get these turnovers.
Pull up Jay. Miss from Riley. Haygood going the other way. Leans in, got the right side of the rim before it's pulled down by Fryer.
That's another bunny that they missed. They get it close to the basket.
Gibbs turns it over again. Scott. Wow. And it's rebounded by Mack.
Both teams are struggling right now from the floor.
From the corner, the miss by Riley. Haygood lobs.
Wow.
Finger roll missed. On Wukamuche, looked like an easy two, and he couldn't hit it.
Yeah, both teams are struggling right now. They're not getting anything in terms of baskets being scored.
Gibbs, couple of trips down, turned it over twice. Collier, top of the key, no good. 3 minutes in and one bucket.
This can happen in rivalry games. Both teams they're too pumped right now. Somebody's got to settle. The first team to settle down is going to take off on a run.
Underneath on Wukamuche, jammed it, but I mean literally.
Yep. He got that one stuck up against the rim. Both teams are playing hard. I think they're playing a little too hard right now, because you got everybody standing up still waiting on that first basket to be scored by Texas Southern. And it is loud in here.
It is loud, it is full. The place seats about 8,000. And we gotta be doggone close. On Wukamuche at the line, Robert Williamson, Van Petaway at the HNPE Center on the campus of Texas Southern University.
55% free throw shooter. Gets the good bounce on that first one. Wholesale substitution by Texas Southern. Coach Davis has seen enough.
Nick Shepard, 6'9". Missouri City, Texas product stepping onto the floor. Meanwhile, you've got David Blanks, the 6'3 junior from Barberton, Ohio. Shepard's a graduate student. Already finished his 4 years working on a grad's degree. Not bad free throw shooting for the big guy. Goes 2 for 2. Official almost ran over our camera guy. First points of the game belong to Chris Thomas.
Texas Southern is happy to see Thomas on the floor. Boy, the action is fast and furious.
Blanks going the other way. Taken away. Hey, good. Instead of the toss to Scott, puts it up for two.
Right now, Prairie View's pressure is the difference in the basketball game. They're relentless on the defensive end, and they're causing all kind of havoc right now for Texas Southern.
But 7-2, Prairie View A&M lead.
But they got the ball in the hand of Old Reliable, and he's trying to settle them down.
Gibbs brings it to the elbow, brings it to the low post. Shot is no good, but the follow-up's a jam from Nick Shepard.
Yep. Nick Shepard has been doing that for the last 6 or 7 ball games. He's giving him that inside presence. And he and Regis are really battling down on the block right now. They're going to get him for steps on that. Yep, Regis tried to lower his shoulder on that one.
So there is a timeout on the floor. With a timeout, we break two. 7-4, Panthers.
Prairie View A&M University is about the students. Students don't just come here for the education. They come for the faculty, for the creativity, the camaraderie, an excellent standard of living, and the school spirit. They come here to gain something profound and to give something back. Students come for the tradition of excellence. This is Prairie View A&M University. Our tradition, your opportunity.
Toyota SWAC Basketball Tournament in Houston, Texas. 5 days of nonstop action, and it all goes down March 10th through the 14th. The SWAC is driven by passion and motivated by pride. Because in the SWAC, history will be made. We do it for the love of the game. Visit www.swachoops.org.
Coach, nearly the entire timeout, Mark Davis was complaining to the officials.
Right, well, Mike is telling them they're being too physical against this press, and he wants the officials to look at it a little closer. Prairie View's applying a lot of pressure, and they've already forced 4 turnovers, so he thinks it's a little too tough.
What a coaching career, too, for Mike Davis.
Another turnover.
Briscoe's got it.
And see what Mike is talking about. They reached behind Gibbs that time and knocked that ball away.
Scott in the paint. Got the 2 despite the efforts of Nick Shepard. You think this game is important to Texas Southern? They were here last night practicing. They were here this afternoon practicing. And a timeout, Mike Davis.
Mike is really upset with the officiating. He's really upset. He wants them to call to reach from behind.
Today's SWAC Digital Network broadcast. It is brought to you in part by Toyota.
They just gave Mike Davis a warning.
Mike Davis has got a warning. The Home Depot making coverage possible. Russell Athletics, we're wearing brand new stuff in prep in the arena. Compliments of Russell. Nike makes coverage possible too, and Of course, we say thanks to the folks who provide Coca-Cola. Mike Davis is hot,
yes,
to
is.
Say the least.
He is. He thinks that the officials are allowing, that they're allowing Prairie View to be overly aggressive on the defensive end. So look for a quick whistle. Now, the referees are going to want to keep this game in check with it being a rivalry game.
And there's that whistle. York coming over the back of Shepherd.
And see, Coach Rim wanted the offensive foul. He felt that his man was in position to take the offensive foul. Coach Davis is happy they blew the whistle. As we look at the replay, Regis is there. He's there on the pass. He's saying the foul should have been called prior to the pass.
So I'm thinking that tonight there may not be a single official's call that both coaches agree with.
Yeah, it's going to be a long night.
Shepherd not happy with the first miss.
He's only a 55% free throw shooter, so he did what's about right. He made the second one.
Still very early into the game, but the intensity level already turned up a notch. Scott with a nice quick move to the hoop, got around the big guy Shepherd.
And yesterday in practice, Texas Southern worked to try to keep him from the cutoff driving lanes for Scott.
Off the glass, bucket good for Riley.
Riley hung in the air and was able to put that one down. Pretty good player.
Hey, good, lobs it to the low post. Onwukamuche, the miss. Couple of short-range misses for Onwukamuche.
Yep, Prairie View is getting it in the paint, but they're missing a lot of bunnies.
Screen set by Shepherd. Gibbs pulls up and fires. Too long. Shepherd got it. And the whistle was blown. Let's see if it's on the guy that was sitting on the hardwood. That was York, or exactly who did what.
Yeah, Shepherd right now is controlling the glass. He's doing a pretty good job. He's giving up his body. Every time that ball goes up, he's in there battling.
And the officials say it was Scott that committed the foul. That will be his first.
And that's a person Prairie View cannot afford to lose. He's got to stay out of foul trouble.
Shepherd back of the line. Went 1-for-2 just a few moments ago. Second shot coming up. And don't forget, stay up to date on all things SWAC and follow us on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and Vine. All by using and searching for the username of the SWAC.
Prairie View still pushing that basketball down the floor. Coach Rim wants early offense. He wants it to be quick. He wants the pace of this game to be fast.
York hands it back over to Haygood.
There's another bunny that was missed.
Wesley Afalayan, a 6'7", 225-pound junior from right here in Houston. A whistle as Riley brought it into the paint, and now it's Byram Rim upset.
Right, he was looking for that walk first. He wanted a walk prior to the foul being called. And as you see, as they get the ball into the post, that was a big step, and he did have two little funny steps on that play. So Coach Rim might have a point there. Riley's a 70% free throw shooter out of Newport, Virginia. And he's claiming Newport, Virginia as his home, but he came here from Selma, Alabama. His father's the police chief down in Selma, Alabama. And he's done an amazing job since Thomas has been out of the lineup.
Scott over to York. York squares up, looks over Riley, puts it on the floor. Jaron Johnson, a 6'3 sophomore from Dallas now in. Rejected by Shepard. Uffelin shot. Bounced on the rim and dropped in for Riley.
Riley battling on the glass. He did a good job on that offensive rebound. Both teams are going to the basket strong tonight.
Uffelin's got into the timeline. Over to York. He will fire a long three. Out off Scott. Texas Southern's got it. Brought in from the baseline, Haygood out of the lineup. Jacoby Green, a 6'4 junior from Houston, checks in for Prairie View.
Coach Rim is getting York out of there. But I guess they're used to him shooting a three-pointer, though, because he's shooting 39% from the three-pointer.
Charleston Dobbs, 6'8 junior from Dumas, Arkansas. In as Scott goes to the sidelines, and a quick foul called.
That was on Green. I think the officials are trying to make sure that they don't let this game get out of hand. They're blowing that whistle a little quicker now.
Nevin Johnson, 6'5 junior from Houston, in now for Texas Southern, and Gibbs brings it to the right side and works the top of the key. Thomas hands to Blanks and then cuts through the paint.
Yes. They got the offensive foul on that particular play. Blanks got in too deep. Defense was there. It's a good call. Coach Davis is not complaining. He knows he got a little too deep. Defense is already there before he leaves the floor.
Nevin Johnson charged with a foul. It's his first. Green over to Johnson. Briscoe over to York. Briscoe drives the lane.
Should be one going the other way. Both teams are trading out now on these offensive fouls. Defense was set, and you got that media timeout coming up.
So with the break here, we take a break on SDN as well. Delighted to be in Houston, Texas, for the big-time rivalry between the Panthers and the Tigers.
Started my Camry, went to the auction, won a storage locker, found an old guitar. Tracked down the previous owner. Reunited them. Hit the jackpot.
The bold new Camry. One bold choice leads to another. Toyota, let's go places.
Welcome to Texas Southern University. Our home is Houston. We are a premier urban university with distinctive undergraduate and graduate programs, innovative research, artistic excellence, and athletic tradition. We are building legends. Your future begins at TSU now.
The 11:46 left of the first half. Lead has changed hands, belonging to Prairie View for the better part of the first 8 or 9 minutes of the game. But now in the hands of Texas Southern, so too is the basketball, as Gibbs will bring it down.
Yep, Texas Southern has settled down now, and they're closing this lead. And this might be, nope, that was not their first three. They have yet to hit a three-point. Right now they're 0-for-3 from the three-point line. And that's been one of their weapons all year.
Johnson tries the three, and there is a whistle. Foul is called, I believe, on Charleston Dobbs. That's his first. It is the sixth called on Prairie View. And there you can see in the low post, there was the shove to the backside of Nevin Johnson.
Right. But Prairie View's going to continue to bring apply pressure. They got to try to speed this game up.
Thomas stumbles, but able to get rid of it first.
I know Coach Davis was watching that fall because this is his first game back after messing up his knee, his ankle. It's a great offensive rebound in there.
Blanks missed it, then made it. Hey, good. Tipped by Onwukamuche.
Yep, Reach is doing a good job in there battling. He's in there by himself a lot of times, but he's putting up a good fight.
Johnson, top of the key to Shepherd. Thomas will send it back out front to Gibbs. The lead one for the home team. Thomas off on the three. Scott back in the lineup, gets the rebound, tosses it down to Haygood.
They're looking to attack every trip down the floor.
Johnson's miss, York had it. It's taken out of his arms, but out of bounds. It's off a Tiger. Thomas.
Referees might have missed one then. They pulled his jersey out of his pants. They were pulling so hard on that rebound.
Literally had a Tiger by the tail.
Yeah.
Hey, good to bring it in for the baseline halfway through the first half.
Resetting that shot clock. As you watch on this replay, they pulled his jersey out of his pants, getting him out of that lane. Referees missed that one.
York sliding it into Onwukamuche for the jam.
He's just giving them that presence in the paint. He's playing real strong tonight.
Taken away. Prairie View, the alley-oop off the glass, no good. York trying to save it. Thomas takes it away. Make that Johnson takes it away. Couple of misses, and Prairie View's got it back. Haygood, long two-pointer.
Right, Haygood knew that one was going down. He saw that one all the way.
Thomas to Johnson, gives into the paint. Scott had it, tipped away by Johnson. Gibbs tries to save it and limps over a photographer in the process.
Got some penetration to drop it off to Reed, and he's hanging on the rim. He does a great job of creating space, and they're able to put that one home.
What's Byron Rim arguing about here with the official? Or doesn't look like an argument, really. Maybe just an advisory statement.
Right. He just wants them to look at certain things. And right now they had six players on the floor, so that I know he didn't want that. He didn't want his five to go against their six. But both teams seem to be settling down now, and we're seeing a very good basketball game.
Bounce pass goes to York at the timeline. Left side looks in on Rukamuche. Trying to get a feel for exactly where Jason Carter, the 6'9 senior, is.
Good move, just came up short. Shooting it over his left shoulder.
Collier gives it to Blanks. Blanks blocked by York. Haygood. Battle to get the loose ball off the Haygood miss. Stepping out with it is Collier.
Coach Davis still looking for calls. He's looking for fouls down on this end. And he has to be careful because the guy that he's talking to is the one that has already given him a warning.
Weren't we here a year ago, or was it, I know it was Texas Southern where right. Both he and Eric Murray were
right.
Tossed right. Out of the game.
Yep. That happens a lot when you have these rivalry games, tensions are so high. I'm real impressed with Prairie View right now. They seem to be the most aggressive team on the floor.
Certainly getting opportunities.
Right, they've missed a bunch of bunnies and you know, at the break, They're still only shooting 25% from the floor, but they're leading the basketball game. And here we go again with penetration, and we've missed another bunny. We got to have – when you're in a tight game like this, you got to have all these little crip shots, as they call them.
Scott puts it in play to Huffelin. And there was a foul called on Malcolm Riley. Seven minutes, 54 seconds left. Half number one. Prairie View by three.
Toyota SWAC Basketball Tournament in Houston, Texas. 5 days of nonstop action, and it all goes down. March 10th through the 14th, the SWAC is driven by passion and motivated by pride. Because in the SWAC, history will be made. We do it for the love of the game. Visit www.swachoops.org.
Started my Camry. Went to the auction. Won a storage locker. Found an old guitar. Tracked down the previous owner. Reunited them. Hit the jackpot.
The bold new Camry. One bold choice leads to another. Toyota, let's go places.
Seven minutes, 54 seconds left to play. Coach, half number one, by the way, looking at the stats. You have got four field goals by Prairie View A&M. You've got four by Texas Southern. Of course, that's changed over the last few moments. But the big difference, though, and I say big, it's very early in the game. The only difference is that one three-pointer.
Right.
And that's the difference currently, 3 points.
And then the other thing, Prairie View's getting more shots. They've already taken 26 field goal attempts to only 18 for Texas Southern. Southern still 0-for-4 from the three-point, and that's been a great big part of their offense.
Neither team shooting particularly well. 27% for Prairie View and nearly 28% for Texas Southern. Haygood, short on the three-point try.
Got
We've got
push.
A whistle.
That was a push in the back. That was real obvious. I saw that from over here, and I don't have on a striped shirt. But we'll go to the free throw line now because that was their seventh. That was their seventh team foul.
Jason Carter, the senior from Houston, will shoot. Ladies of Texas Southern already beating Prairie View. 70-55 was the final in that one.
Wow, you missed the free throw and then you turn around and you make a foul. I know Coach Davis is not going to be happy about that.
Collier trying to save it, did the long snap, and Jason Carter tried to get the rebound off that bounce and
you
fouled
see,
Haygood.
And you see Coach Davis took him out of the game. You compounded the problem with a foul. You missed a free throw and then you come across the back.
Haygood's got it over to Green, brings it topside to York. Scott with Gibb trailing him. Fadeaway misses the three. Tipped away from Collier, but Gibb's able to get it back. 3-point try from Collier. He nails
the first
it.
One.
First three of the game for Texas Southern.
Let's see if that gets Texas Southern going. A lot of times a dunk or a 3-point shot will ignite your team.
Hey, good. Try to slide it over to the guy who can indeed dunk it. Onwukamuche gets away from him, headed the other way, blanks.
Heat check.
Collier with a miss. Scott. Over to Haygood. Green fires the three.
Both teams still finding a hard time finding that basket.
Gibbs. If it's offensive, the bucket won't count.
Yep, that's against Gibbs. He was, the defense was there all day. Coach Davis can't be mad with that call now because you could, I think Ray Charles can see that the defense was already there.
Six-21. Left to play in the first half. Handoff goes to Green, over to Scott.
Regis didn't even look at the basket that time. If he looked, he would have found out that he was in there by himself.
York whips it over to Onwukamuche. Blanks going the other way. It's a one-on-two break. Blanks says, I like the odds, and he is fouled by Green.
He got a foul out of it, but that was a tough one now.
Blanks heads to the line.
He's only a 65% free throw shooter.
Junior from Ohio.
Yeah, he got bailed out on this one.
Struggling at the line.
Yep, 65% free throw shooter. He's been there 49 times, and he's just not converting them.
Blank's trying to give his Tigers the lead. It dips in and out.
Low-scoring ball game because both teams can't seem to find the range.
And both teams shooting in the low percentages. There is a foul. And yes, it's Malcolm Riley.
Yeah, they got Riley on the knee that time. Coming off the screen, he got his knee out there.
Fans, the 2015 SWAC Men's and Women's Golf Championship takes place in Louisiana in April. Be sure to check it out. There's what got the foul called.
Johnson's an 83% free throw shooter.
Both teams have had an opportunity to break the 17-all tie at the line, and both teams have failed.
83% and he bricks it.
Shepard hands it over to Gibbs. Thomas. In it goes to Collier. Turnaround is a miss on the grab by Johnson.
Yeah, the game is a little too slow, I think, for Prairie View. I know for a fact Coach Rim talked about his team had to force tempo and it had to be up tempo for his team to be successful. But with both teams missing so many shots, it's a very low scoring game.
Hey, good. Line drive catches the rim. Blanks. The alley-oop. Shepard.
Think we're going to have a push on that one.
Blanks, I think, had the two.
Yeah, he had it. He had it. They tried to go for the great highlight reel. When in a game like this, you need the basket. You need to score. Shepard's going to the line, and he's only a 55% free throw shooter.
And so far today is 0-for. Still 17-all. And a third opportunity for somebody to break the 17-all tie at the line.
Yeah, well, they got Shepard down for being, well, he's shooting 50%. He's a 55% free throw shooter in the game. He's shooting 50%. He was able to put that one down.
Inside 5 minutes to play, half number one.
I don't think coming into this game, either coach felt that this would be a low-scoring affair. Everybody thought this would be a high-powered game.
Onwukamuche had it, lost it. Scott comes up with it. As Shepard stays right about his season average at the line. Scott pulls up at the elbow.
Good.
Got the bounce.
Good soft touch on that one.
Alabama State has already won tonight. Southern University and Jackson State victorious today as well.
Another turnover.
Over it goes to Scott. From the short corner, count the bucket. And Zachary Hamilton, the 6'4 freshman from Houston, now in.
Nice stroke coming out of that corner. Now Texas Southern's being patient against this full court pressure.
Thomas walking into the right side, brought it at the elbow, kicks it over to Tyree Bynum, a 5'9 sophomore from Philadelphia, inserted into the lineup. Bynum pulls up, short on the shot.
Because Rim was looking for a walk on that one.
Haygood.
Wow.
The miss picked up by Gibbs.
Haygood still looking for a foul on that one.
It's 4-on-1. And usually that results in at least two.
And Coach Rim had to get that quick timeout because he did not like the fact that his kids didn't get back. Haygood was looking for the foul, and he stayed down on the floor on the other end. And when you're struggling for points, you can't allow your opponent to run out on you like that. 4-on-1.
21-20. 3:18 to go. We've already talked about golf. What about bowling? Fans, don't forget to support the 2015 SWAC Women's Bowling Championship held at the Bowling International Training and Research Center in Arlington, Texas. It happens March 20th through 22nd. We are back at it on a week from Monday. Heading off to Pine Bluff, Arkansas, as Alcorn State will take on the University of Arkansas at Pine Bluff.
I know Coach Rim didn't want to call that timeout because he, on the next dead ball, it's going to be a media timeout. But he had to address that situation with his team because every point is going, every basket is going to count in this game.
Johnson over to Scott. Scott moving from the left to the right side of the key. Gives it back to Johnson. Tip down. Bynum's got it. Collier got it back. Just took it away. Wanted it more. Took it away from Zachary Hamilton.
Real aggressive. Being real aggressive in there. Going after that offensive rebound.
Johnson, handoff goes to Green. Green looking to the sidelines, picking up instructions from Byron Rim II. 10th year at Prairie View, 9 is the head coach. Mike Davis, second season at TSU. Scott for three.
Montrell been looking for that shot all night. That's just their second three-point shot being made tonight.
Pull up from the short corner. Byram short on the shot. Follow-up is good, though. And that
Collier.
Is Tony Collier.
Yeah, Collier did a good job of crashing the glass.
Spin move by Green. Hamilton with a miss. Able to reach up and get it was Green. Fires, no good. Gibbs takes it to the Tiger into the floor. Shoves it to the hoop for two, and the Tigers reclaim the lead.
They worked on that running jumper yesterday. That jump stop, Coach Davis teaches that, and Gibbs did a good job with that.
Over it goes to Scott on the timeline. Lost it, stays down on the floor, and he may be hurt. He is in some pain, writhing in pain. And there is a timeout, which we will turn into a media timeout and try to check out the status of Scott.
Over goes Scott on the timeline.
See if we can see what happened. Just maybe stepped on Gibbs' foot. Is that what created the problem? Let's see. May have stepped on somebody's foot, but he is down. He is injured, but he's being helped up, and maybe we'll see him back in the game a little bit later on. There's a timeout on the floor and some media timeout. Let's take a break, too, as Texas Southern has claimed the two-point lead.
Bang knees. Bang knees.
Tournament in Houston, Texas. 5 days of nonstop action, and it all goes down March 10th through the 14th. The SWAC is driven by passion and motivated by pride, because in the SWAC, history will be made. We do it for the love of the game. Visit www.swachoops.org.
Started my Camry, went to the auction, won a storage locker, found an old guitar. Tracked down the previous owner. Reunited them. Hit the jackpot.
The bold new Camry. One bold choice leads to another. Toyota, let's go places.
It was the right knee of Scott that got injured. Didn't look like any kind of tear, just maybe some kind of contact.
Right, and it might even be a thigh bruise. The way he's working his leg over there, it might even be higher than his knee. It might be a knee to his thigh. As we can see on the replay, oh, that's knee to knee. Yeah, that was a knee to knee.
And that was a big knee he ran into.
Yeah, I think he ran into Shepard's knee.
Yep.
And now Shepard seems like he's limping coming back on the floor. Or is that just the walk that they have where, see, Shepard is from Missouri City, Texas. Maybe that's the walk that they have in Missouri City.
Gim steps across midcourt as action resumes. 2-point Texas Southern lead.
Now, within a minute, both teams want to make sure they don't foul going into this half.
Thomas bounce pass to Bynum. Shot clock down to single digits. Bynum in the paint, off the glass, off the rim, and the rebound picked up by Shepard.
So they can go for the last shot, and I think that's what Gibbs is telling everybody, we're going to do this one more time.
That's what a 6'9 graduate student will do for you. If you're not a grad student, maybe you're bringing it back to the hoop, slamming it in, but he realized, hey, let's run the final time off the clock and get a bucket.
And he's one of the people that Coach Davis was talking about yesterday who had an opportunity to come here to play, whereas where he transferred from, he was not getting that many minutes.
Whoa. Stolen away by Haygood. Offensive, too.
Wow, that was Thomas on that drive. And
I don't think Mike Davis agreed.
Nope. Well, actually, he seems like he's more mad with Thomas for running over the guy. In fact, he's still talking to him about that play.
Hamilton puts it in play. 6 seconds left in the half. An opportunity for Prairie View to tie it up. Hey, good. Over it goes from the corner.
Didn't even get a shot off. You got to be able to get a shot off.
So even if he hit it, wouldn't have counted. It is halftime. It's a 26-24 halftime lead. And Jasher has got the head coach of Prairie View A&M. Let's turn it over to Jasher.
All right, Coach, close ball game here so far. Talk about your first half.
Well, I mean, you know, we were doing what we were supposed to do, and then we started letting selfishness kick in a little bit. We started making stupid plays. You got to work the offense around and make sure we stay smart and make sure we don't get them on fast breaks.
What are the keys in your mind in the second half?
Offense, I mean, we got defensive rebound. We got to make sure we're limiting the one shot. We're doing a great job defensively, but then we're giving them a rebound.
Good luck in the second half. Thanks a lot, Coach. All right, Rob, thanks. Back to you guys.
All right, thanks so much, Jasher. He is down by two, but I think he knows why he's down by two and not happy about it.
Right.
It is halftime, and it's the Tigers by a couple.
Toyota SWAC Basketball Tournament in Houston, Texas. 5 days of nonstop action, and it all goes down March 10th through the 14th. The SWAC is driven by passion and motivated by pride, because in the SWAC, history will be made. We do it for the love of the game. Visit www.swachoops.org.
Started my Camry. Went to the auction. Won a storage locker. Found an old guitar. Tracked down the previous owner. Reunited them. Hit the jackpot.
The bold new Camry. One bold choice leads to another. Toyota, let's go places.
Welcome to Texas Southern University. Our home is Houston. We are a premier urban university with distinctive undergraduate and graduate programs, innovative research, artistic excellence, and athletic tradition. We are building legends. Your future begins at TSU now.
Prairie View A&M University is about the students. Students don't just come here for the education. They come for the faculty, for the creativity, the camaraderie, an excellent standard of living, and the school spirit. They come here to gain something profound and to give something back. Students come for the tradition of excellence. This is Prairie View A&M University. Our tradition, your opportunity.
It is halftime, and the advantage belongs to Texas Southern, but not by much. It's a two-point lead, 26-24 here in the half. Coach, how does Texas Southern expand that lead? Two's not satisfactory to Mike Davis and company.
Well, first of all, they got to stop turning the ball over. They already have 10 turnovers, and the guy that we featured, Gibbs, he has four of those 10. He started the game out with two straight turnovers, and right now he's their floor general. He only has two assists and four turnovers. You can't have that if they're going to be successful.
Well, we might as well take a look at Maurice Gibbs and exactly what he's done in the first half. You mentioned the turnovers. You mentioned the lack of assist for Maurice Gibbs. He's a guy, though, that is nonstop. He's the Iron Man. He's going to play an entire ball game. So what's he got to do in the second half?
Well, in the second half, Madarius has to make sure that he controls the tempo of the game, and he's got to make sure he finds his shooter. If he can get somebody on, but as a team, they only shoot 33% from the floor and only 1 of 8 from the three-point line. So when he can find a guy to get in the groove, he's got to feed that guy. And he must control the basketball, and he cannot turn it over.
Well, obviously, this is a very important ball game to both, but especially for Texas Southern if they are going to hang with Alabama State atop the conference standings. Taking a look at the standings, Alabama State, they are now 9-1 as they beat UAPB tonight. And so that means they're a half game up on Texas Southern. Mike Davis not happy with a two-point lead at the half.
No, he's not. He's not happy. He's not happy with the execution. They should have gotten it. They should have gone for the last. They were trying to go for the last shot in the half, and Thomas went too deep and ran over the guy and ended up getting that offensive foul. But they've got to play a little bit smarter, and they got to find somebody to get in the room.
And obviously, all teams trying to get the highest seeding possible so that they have the easiest slate, if there is an easy slate, when you get to the SWAC basketball tournament in Houston. It happens the 10th through the 14th, Beyond the Rim. I love this year's motto because it is definitely Beyond the Rim. It's not
right.
Just about basketball. It's about music. It's about fellowship. It's about meeting old friends, making new ones, and more.
And when it comes to the players, they're playing Beyond the Rim. You got a lot of leapers in this league this year, and they are really doing a fantastic job. It's going to be some great basketball.
So you get your tickets at SWAC.org, SWACHoops.org, and then there's some of that music. My wife is going, hey, are we going to that thing? I want to see Salt-N-Pepa. So Salt-N-Pepa, 112 the old school concert. It's all part of all the festivities taking place there in Houston, Texas at the Toyota Center Water Complex. Last year, sensational event. This year, we're not going to be disappointed. It'll be the same or better.
Not at all. Not at all. I think all the teams are looking forward to getting there. And I know the fans need to be planning now to spend the entire week in Houston.
Halftime here, 26-24. Texas Southern, game two of our twin bill. Ladies of Texas Southern have already won it. And the men lead it by a couple.
There are some moments you spend your life preparing for. Not to prove them wrong, but yourself right. So you work harder, drive stronger, and before you know it, you didn't just beat the game.
Who is that?
Don't know, but he's going places.
You changed it.
Hey, son, ready for the interview?
I got this.
Introducing the 2014 Next Generation Corolla. Toyota, let's go places.
In 1920, six schools came together to form a strong competitive alliance. That strong competitive alliance became the Southwestern Athletic Conference and stretches from the northeast of Alabama to the rolling plains of Texas, from the coastal marshlands of Louisiana to the Mississippi Delta to the foothills of Arkansas. Students of these 10 world-class institutions know the importance of academic achievement along with athletic excellence. We are proud of our past and value our traditions. We will always stand as one. Alabama A&M. Alabama State. Alcorn State. Grambling State. Jackson State. Mississippi Valley State. Prairie View A&M. Southern. Texas Southern. Arkansas Pine Bluff. We are the Southwestern Athletic Conference. Honor the heritage.
Toyota SWAC Basketball Tournament in Houston, Texas. 5 days of nonstop action, and it all goes down March 10th through the 14th. The SWAC is driven by passion and motivated by pride. Because in the SWAC, history will be made. We do it for the love of the game. Visit www.swaghoops.org.
Welcome back, and there in the middle of the floor, as you see, they just had a cheerleading battle, and we got camera guys that are like 25 years old, so we, you know, we kind of had to pull them aside from the cheerleader battle. Hey, this is a very important month. February is Black History Month. And there are really some super representatives from both schools, Prairie View A&M and Texas Southern. But we want to shine the spotlight on a couple. For Prairie View, Charlie Brackens. He played college football at Prairie View A&M University in Prairie View, Texas from 51 to 55. He was a three-year starter for legendary head football coach Billy Nix. Led the Panthers to 33 wins in 37 games in the SWAC. He was a big, tall, I like the way they say this, a big, tall passer at 6'2". You know, you got the Cam Newtons at 6'6". And Brackens was drafted by the Green Bay Packers in the 16th round of the 55 NFL draft, making him the first HBCU alumnus to play quarterback in the NFL. And, of course, for Texas Southern, there's a guy that you are seeing everywhere these days.
Everywhere.
Yes. Michael Strahan, he was inducted into the 2014 NFL Hall of Fame last summer, and he's played his entire NFL career, or did, with the Giants. Played defensive end at Texas Southern, mounted up 41 career sacks, currently a football analyst on Fox NFL Sunday, also serves as co-host on the television morning talk show Live with Kelly and Michael, alongside Kelly Ripa. Boy, he's just everywhere doing everything and just speaks well for Texas Southern, and obviously worthy of recognition.
Oh, yes, and then he's also joined the morning show right there at ABC, and he's, by the mere fact that he's been on there, they have elevated their ratings, and they're in the number one talk show now in the morning.
He's
a difference maker off the field also.
Indeed he is. Hey, we are going to, for the first time, I think that you and I will go to the University of Arkansas at Pine Bluff and do a game that happens a week from Monday when Alcorn takes on the Golden Lions.
Right, and that'll be a nice place. That's a nice arena to play in. Their fans are very passionate, and I look forward to a great ball game.
UAPB, inexplicably, they go on those tears where you win a bunch of games and you beat some really tough teams like this one, and then you lose some games that you should have won.
Right, but then when they're at home, or they're a different ball club, I expect them to really, really come out and be ready to play against Alcorn. And I know George Ivory is going to have those kids ready to play.
So we will be there and bring the action to you live here on the SWAC Digital Network as Alcorn State travels to Arkansas to take on UAPB. That happens a week from Monday. Here's what we got just ahead. Another great half of basketball, Texas Southern and Prairie View A&M.
Prairie View A&M University is about the students. Students don't just come here for the education. They come for the faculty, for the creativity, the camaraderie, an excellent standard of living, and the school spirit. They come here to gain something profound and to give something back. Students come for the tradition of excellence. This is Prairie View A&M University. Our tradition, your opportunity.
Welcome to Texas Southern University. Our home is Houston. We are a premier urban university with distinctive undergraduate and graduate programs, innovative research, artistic excellence, and athletic tradition. We are building legends. Your future begins at TSU now.
Started my Camry, went to the auction, won a storage locker, found an old guitar. Tracked down the previous owner. Reunited them. Hit the jackpot.
The bold new Camry. One bold choice leads to another. Toyota, let's go places.
We've already talked about Texas Southern and the guy that we chatted about in pregame, Madarius Gibbs. What about the gentleman, Montrell Scott, who we featured in pregame?
Well, Montrell's living up to his billing. He's 5 out of 7 from the floor, 2 out of 3 from the line. He already has 12 points, 5 rebounds, but he got hurt right there before the end of the half. So we got to find out how severe his injury is and if he'll be able to come back. Because right now, he's doing everything for Prairie. He scored 12. He's got half of their points.
So if he's not in the lineup, if he's not up to full speed in the second half, what's that mean for Prairie View?
That means Prairie View is going to struggle in this second half.
It's just plain and simple.
Yep. They're going to struggle.
Well,
he's done an outstanding job. He's been playing real well, and I'm trying to watch him in warm-up. He seems to be moving pretty decent. But he's still flexing that knee right now. So, Robert, I don't know if...
Can you win if he's not in the lineup in the second half?
Well, with the way they've been shooting the basketball, he's the only one that's been shooting with any kind of consistency. I think it'll be tough for Prairie View to win without him on the floor.
Minute 42 seconds from now, we will see how he fares. Jasher trying to track down Mike Davis, head coach of Texas Southern. 2-point advantage, and I think he is in the process of snagging Mr. Davis.
Yeah, he's got him over there.
So we will send it directly to Jasher.
All right, Coach, you're up by 2 at the half. What did you tell your team?
Well, I thought PB came out and just played at another level. They were cutting really hard. We wasn't ready for the pace that they played. And so we just got to come out and give more effort on both ends of the court.
How do you get something going offense can have?
Well, we just got to take what's given to them. We got to drive the basketball. When they collapse, kick the ball out to the open guy. I thought we missed a lot of open shots. We missed 6 free throws. So you put the free throws with the open shots, we should be up about 12 or 15 points because they shot the ball really poor in the first half.
Good luck in the second half, Coach. Thanks a lot. All right, back to you guys. Thanks a lot.
All right, thank you very much, Jasher. So despite the fact he's on top, that is not a happy Mike Davis.
Right, because Mike knows that he's at home. He's got to have a better effort out of his team in order to come out of here with a win tonight.
free throws, too many missed free throws, according to Mike Davis. And this is a team, though, that went the extra mile. They practiced yesterday. They practiced this morning. Can you practice too much, though?
No, I don't think you can, not at this time of the year. And I think what he's the big word, the big thing that he talked about was effort. Prairie View came out with more effort than his team did at the beginning of the ball game. And they had to expend a lot of energy to get back into the game.
Let's see. Really, we don't know who's going to win this thing. It's a two-point advantage.
It's anybody's ball game.
That's right. The lead is swapped hands. Texas Southern came from a deficit that was about 5 or 6 points. Took the lead. It wasn't particularly large, but did take the advantage. Prairie View comes back, takes the lead. It seesawed back and forth for a bit. And so here we are heading into the second half, and it's a two-point advantage for Texas Southern.
And that's a good sign for the Prairie View fan, for the Panther fans, to see Montrell Scott jogging out on the floor.
So Scott out there ready to do business along with the other gentleman who started the game for Prairie View A&M. That, of course, being Onwukamuche, Haygood, Briscoe, and York. Meanwhile, Texas Southern, they've got Gibbs, they've got Riley. Thomas is beginning the second half. Shepherd as well.
Along with Blanks.
So a different look in the second half as compared to the start of the first half for Texas Southern.
I think Coach Davis wanted to get some people on the floor that are going to drive the basketball like he's talking about. They just drove it. They missed, but they got the offensive rebound and missed another bunny. So we started the second half off like we ended the first half, missing easy shots.
And as a matter of fact, it was about 2 or 3 minutes into the ball game before any damage was done in the first half.
Right. So Texas Southern, they've got to find somebody that they can count on consistently.
Shepherd rejects Scott's shot. And then York lost into the paint. Thomas comes up with it. Thomas. And it is swatted away. Riley trying to stick it in the corner. Picked up by Briscoe, and Briscoe lays it in.
Right. Speed. Speed won that battle.
Gibbs, who had a rough first half, did not come off the floor. Gives it over to Thomas. Thomas pulls up on the line and is able to sink it over on Wukamuche.
Yeah, that's what Texas Southern has been missing. With Thomas with that ankle injury and first game back, he looked pretty good on that shot.
Hey, good. A glance to the sidelines. Instructions forthcoming from Byron Rim. Hey, good at the stripe. York. Maybe got a little too anxious. He was already thinking about the three.
Right. He was looking to shoot before he got the ball.
On Wukamuche off the glass.
That's a great, good power move. Got the basketball. Got down in the paint and turned and went up strong. And that's what he's got to do.
Blanks working the dribble to the left side. Gives it right side to Riley into the corner. That is Thomas. Off on the three, and Blanks couldn't put it back. Briscoe to Scott. Scott, by the way, has that knee bandaged, so apparently broke some skin as Haygood puts it up and in.
Yep, that was a nice offensive rebound.
Blanks top of the key, picks it up. Riley into the corner to Thomas.
See, that's what Thomas does best. He puts that ball on the floor. Coach Davis said yesterday, he's definitely the best driver that they have on the floor. He's the strongest driver that they have on the floor.
York charged with a foul, his first. It's the first of the second half for A&M. Giovanni Mack, the 5'9 freshman, checking in.
See, now Coach Davis, now he's got to get in his head because he didn't like the way he was responding to him when he was on the floor. So Coach Davis took Blanks out, and now he's letting him know how he really feels about the situation.
Joshua Fryer back into the lineup, too. Just didn't see a whole lot of Fryer and Giovanni, despite the fact they both started the ball game earlier. Gibbs blocked by Onwukamuche.
good strong move to the basket, but they were waiting on him.
Briscoe pulls up, drops it in.
And that's Prairie View getting it out in transition before Texas Southern can get back and set the defense up.
Max got it on the right side. Fryer set the screen. Underneath, off the glass, Riley. Bucket counts and he's fouled.
That was a good look, good look.
Opportunity to cap off a three-point play. Join us for the 2015 SWAC Softball Tournament in the Wilson Morgan Park in Decatur, Alabama. It happens May 6th through 9th. Also baseball, 13th through the 17th of May in New Orleans.
Great pass down in there. That was a great pass. Riley showed good hands. Then he was able to deliver on the free throw line.
Lots of time left in this one. A one-point game, Prairie View A&M.
Scott hadn't had a good look at the basket this half. He's turning the corner to get his first look.
And the miss is retrieved by Thomas.
That's only his third miss of the night.
Gibbs on the other end. Swatted away by Onwukamuche. Briscoe saves it. Hey, good. Two on three. Waits for teammates.
Scott had a good ball fake.
York off on the three. Haygood had it. It's taken away and pushed out of bounds by Riley. A look again at the Onwukamuche block. Impressive. 15:50 left to play.
Prairie View A&M University is about the students. Students don't just come here for the education. They come for the faculty, for the creativity, the camaraderie, an excellent standard of living, and the school spirit. They come here to gain something profound and to give something back. Students come for the tradition of excellence. This is Prairie View A&M University. Our tradition, your opportunity.
Welcome to Texas Southern University. Our home is Houston. We are a premier urban university with distinctive undergraduate and graduate programs, innovative research, artistic excellence, and athletic tradition. We are building legends. Your future begins at TSU now.
There is a quartet of retired numbers that certainly played some stellar basketball here. Benny Swain, Gaylord Davis, Alonzo Bradley, Marcella Singleton.
And you also got Harry Kelly and Kevin Granger. Machine Gun Kelly was one of the guys that really lit up not only this conference, but he played after he left here also.
Action resumes. Prairie View A&M with a basketball and a one-point lead. Over it goes to York. And York got a really good look.
Yeah, he was able to get that baseline move in and put that one in. Prairie View doing a pretty good job of attacking along the baseline.
Gibbs works it out front, sends it over to Riley. And Riley will pop the three.
Now, if he gets going, it's going to be tough in here tonight. He's up to 12 points. He leads Texas Southern in scoring right now.
Tied again, this time at 34. Briscoe to Scott. Hey, good to the stripe, and there's contact, and I believe the contact was initiated by the guy wearing gray.
Yeah, I think Carter's going to come up with that foul. He tried to get there, but he was a little slow.
Just the first foul of the second half for Texas Southern.
It's not a shooting foul, so they'll be taking it out under the basket. We'll see if they're going to try to score on the inbound.
York wanted it at the low post. Instead, he will come out, set the screen, and now Briscoe will give it to York. York will drive, shot misses. Carter kicks it over to Gibbs. Carter for three. And it is Scott coming up with a loose ball.
Right now, Prairie View is only limiting them to one shot, and that's good. Works in their favor. But I think they're going to get Riley on this one.
Scott heading to the line, and it is indeed Malcolm Riley who's pleading his case with the official, going, well, guys, I just had my hands up.
Yep.
And, you know, it's not my fault.
Yep. And as you can see, Scott is looking to penetrate. He gets in there, and he creates the contact. He caught Riley moving. He creates the contact, able to put it up. Now, Scott's only a 66% free throw shooter. He's able to put that one down. He's doing a little bit better in this game. That was his first time to the line, so he's one for one tonight. And he's leading Texas Southern with 13 points now. I'm sorry, he's leading Prairie View with 13 points now.
Number 36-34, Prairie View with the advantage.
And they're coming back with this pressure, trying to speed up the game.
I think Byron Rim had a coat on earlier, but it's getting too warm in here for a coat. He's got that thing off.
Yep. He's working tonight.
Gibbs sends it over to Thomas. Off the rim from Collier.
I'm not sure if Coach Davis wanted that shot from Collier.
Briscoe bringing it baseline, then we'll send it out front to Haygood.
They got a mismatch on the block.
York fouled as he brought it inside.
York saw the mismatch. His teammates recognized the mismatch and got the ball into York on the block. Good, smart basketball.
Giovanni Mack picking up his second foul. And right there, just yep, that reach in to try to swipe the round ball away.
York is only a 59% free throw shooter. Look good on that one.
One more for Kareem York, 6'9", 225-pounder. Played at Howard College in Region 5 of the NJCAA before coming here to Prairie View A&M.
That was his first 2 points of the night also.
And the four-point lead, I believe, is Prairie View's largest lead of the game.
Yes.
Might have had a five-point lead earlier, but not much more, and it didn't stay long. Turn around. Carter on Wukamuche, distracts Scott, back to Briscoe, finds a seam to the glass for two.
Good ball move. Scott is not only a scorer, he's a facilitator. He was able to hit the man cutting to the basket.
And there's a whistle prior to Blanks bringing it to the glass.
Yeah, they got a reaching foul. Yeah, Regis reached out and he touched someone on that one.
On Wukamuche, charged with a foul. That is Thomas. Top of the key three. It misses, and there's another whistle.
They're going to get him for the hold. Now that's two back-to-back fouls. Coach Rim has a look at that, because now he's up to three fouls. But the problem is he's got two back-to-back.
And he will come out of the lineup. Charleston Dobbs gets back in.
Yeah,
Texas Southern brings it in from the baseline, and there's another foul. This one on York.
Yep.
That is three fouls in the span of about 15 seconds.
All right, might be less than that. Because they came, two of them came during a dead ball situation.
Non-shooting, it will be brought in from right here in front of the broadcast booth.
Got Thomas coming over. Prairie View has made their declaration that my man won't score.
Thomas tried to get it inside to Collier, stolen away. Hey, good. Over to Scott. Scott with a pull-up J. And it winds up in the hands of Blanks.
Good shot, just didn't fall for him.
Over into the corner. Gibbs for three, rims out. Thomas gives his Texas Southern Tigers another opportunity. Blanks for two.
Good baseline move by Blanks.
Briscoe back out front to Haygood. Back over to Briscoe. Haygood, couple of misses. And it is Blanks that comes away with it. Kicked out by Scott. 11:49 to go. 40-36. The visitors from a little bit northwest of here.
Toyota SWAC Basketball Tournament in Houston, Texas. 5 days of nonstop action, and it all goes down March 10th through the 14th. The SWAC is driven by passion and motivated by pride. Because in the SWAC, history will be made. We do it for the love of the game. Visit www.swachoops.org.
Prairie View A&M University is about the students. Students don't just come here for the education. They come for the faculty, for the creativity, the camaraderie, an excellent standard of living, and the school spirit. They come here to gain something profound and to give something back. Students come for the tradition of excellence. This is Prairie View A&M University. Our tradition, your opportunity.
Looking at the stats, it is shooting percentages that are very low for both teams.
Well, Prairie View shooting a lot better in the second half, 46% to only 26% for Texas Southern. And that might be the reason why they got the full-point lead.
31% for both teams overall, 18% from behind the arc for Prairie View, 14 for Texas Southern. And it has turned into a low-scoring game as a result. Collier missing on the three-pointer. Hey, good. Sends it over to Briscoe. Out front, Briscoe's got it. Brings it to the glass, off the glass and rim, and it is Shepard who will send it out to Gibbs. Gibbs off the glass, the miss. Shepard's got it. Trying to get out of the paint with it, and he was mugged, and Haygood's got it going the other way.
Yeah, that's what made Coach Davis mad. I really felt like they may have missed one then.
Haygood from the stripe. Banged it in.
Yep, hit every part of the rim on that one, but it still counts.
Gibbs has 2 points in the game. Leading scorer for this Texas Southern squad. Collier off on the three. Not the shot selection that Mike Davis wanted.
Right, and Mike is still looking for, he wants people to go to the basket.
Briscoe with the handoff to Haygood. Back it goes to Briscoe. Into the paint, whips it over to Haygood. Tipped out, Thomas with it.
Right now, Prairie View is being more aggressive on the offensive end because they're trying to get in the lane.
Blanks. Got it back and put it in. Haygood, a glance to the sidelines. Rim giving the offense instructions. Nolan Wilson, a 6'6 freshman from Laredo, Texas, into the game now. First time that we have seen Nolan Wilson. And there is a foul, and it's on the guy we are talking about right on cue, Nolan Wilson.
Illegal screen on that baseline. And they didn't need that. They had a pretty good offense going. Coach Rim taking it straight out of the game.
So the time on the floor for Nolan Wilson, short-lived. On Wukumuche with the three personals back into the ballgame.
As you can see, he backed into the defender, and the official was standing right there, so you're not going to get away with that on the baseline.
Gibbs trying to get around Haygood. Pretty good defense, but still Gibbs for two.
Right, better offense. That was great defense, but better offense. And all day in practice yesterday, Coach Davis had his guards working on that kind of move going to the basket.
On Wukumuche trying to spin move and then lost it out of bounds.
Last two possessions, Prairie View's got nothing out of it. Got a foul on the baseline and then a turnover.
Gibbs now with four in the game. Will walk across midcourt. Slips and somehow maintain the dribble. Fade away. Off the right side of the rim.
Coach Rim came with a half-court trap then to try to change the pace up, and it worked for him.
42-40. At stake for Texas Southern is staying atop with Alabama State, the SWAC.
One official was going to call the ball out of bounds. One got the foul. Official with the foul takes precedent.
There's about 6,000 people in the stands that didn't agree.
Prairie View trying to be patient now.
York with a screen. Briscoe brings it right side. Back out front, York with it. Shot clock down to 15 as Haygood brings it into the paint and fades away from outside of that lane for two.
Everything Prairie View is doing is going toward the basket. They're trying to turn the corner and get toward the basket.
Nice job by Shepard. Shepard took Onwukumuche out of the picture and blanks. Got the two.
When he saw his teammate driving to the basket, he just turned around and sealed it.
Scott working into the post, then kicks it back out front to Haygood. A couple of guys that haven't spent much time on the sideline, Scott and Haygood. A little behind on Wukumuche, but when you got a long wingspan,
right,
you can reach back and get it.
Right. That was a bad pass, but a better athlete with long arms was able to save that play.
Blanks back out front to Gibbs.
Last couple of plays, Blanks put the ball on the floor and got to the basket. He's on his way again. Good pass.
Thomas for two.
That was a good pass. Blanks got great penetration, was able to drop it off to Thomas. Shepard wants to get out of the game. Coach Davis just not recognized. But he's got a media timeout coming up on the next dead ball.
York coming out to set the screen. Blanks goes around it. Haygood goes around the world to get underneath the basket. There is a jump ball. And the possession error will keep us on that end of the floor, but that will happen after the timeout. 6:37 to play, and still just one teeny tiny bucket separates the Panthers and the Tigers.
Welcome to Texas Southern University. Our home is Houston. We are a premier urban university with distinctive undergraduate and graduate programs, innovative research, artistic excellence, and athletic tradition. We are building legends. Your future begins at TSU now.
Started my Camry, went to the auction, won a storage locker, found an old guitar. Tracked down the previous owner. Reunited them. Hit the jackpot.
The bold new Camry. One bold choice leads to another. Toyota, let's go places.
Robert, look at the people standing up against the walls up there.
They are all over the place here at H&P E Center on the campus of Texas Southern University. The house is definitely full as we watch basketball from the perfect location right here at midcourt.
Right. This has been a great basketball game. And, Robert, I hate to tell you this, but at the rate we're going, we're going to see overtime.
You had to say it, didn't you?
Yeah.
You want to spend a little extra time here in Houston. It is a 46-44 game. Prairie View A&M with the advantage. Texas Southern, we already know that Alabama State has beaten UAPB 70-55. So to stay tied with the Hornets for the SWAC lead, they got to win tonight. Southern University, a 58-50 winner over Grambling State. Grambling still trying to get back on track.
Yeah, it's been tough.
And Jackson State, a 64-61 winner over Alcorn in games earlier. Hey, good for three.
He had to shoot that, and he made it. Shot clock was running down. And Shepard just, he just turned his hands up and say, hey. I mean, Haygood just turned his hands up and say, I had to shoot it.
Banked it off the glass.
It still counts.
And Blank's bringing it inside. You know me, I'd settle for anything I could make, whether hit the glass or not.
Yep.
Embarrasses these guys, though. Yeah. You know, they don't want glass. Blank's going to the stripe.
And that was a big foul now. Keep up with this. It's a six-minute mark. Regis just picked up his fourth foul. That's going to hurt Prairie View because he's been so dominant. He already has 10 points and six rebounds, but he's going to have to sit for a while.
And out comes on Wukabuche.
And Blanks, that's his first. He was 0 for 2 for the night. That was his first free throw that he's made in tonight's game.
Charleston Dobbs coming in as on Wukabuche goes to the sidelines.
That'll give Blanks 10 points. That puts him up there with Malcolm Riley. They're both in double digits for Texas Southern.
Hey, good over to Scott. Scott's been relatively quiet. Don't know if it was the knee, but he's been quiet in the second half as Riley commits the foul.
And I think the combination of the knee and Texas Southern doing a better job in the second half of cutting him away from the basketball.
Non-shooting foul. That's just the fifth this half by Texas Southern.
Right. They've been doing a pretty good job of defending without fouling.
Three double-digit scores for Prairie View A&M. On Wukabuche and Haygood with 10. Scott with 14. One for Texas Southern. That's Riley with 12.
Well, two now that Blanks hit those two free throws.
True. So now a pair of double-digit Tigers. York with a wall.
Well, he walked all over the place. And he had the open path to the basket. All he had to do was put it up.
Briscoe did a little gnawing on York as the two went to the other end of the floor. Thomas pulls up top of the key. Over it goes to Nevin Johnson now in, and looks like Dobbs may have committed the foul.
Yep, they're going to get 22 for that. Dobbs is going to pick that one up.
Johnson, the 6'5 junior from right here in Houston, will be shooting. Obviously, one of the largest metros in the United States, produces a lot of talent. You've got both rosters full of Houston natives.
Pretty good free throw shooter, too, at 86% coming into this game.
Thought for a moment it wasn't going to happen, but it did.
And you can get a post player shoot 86% from the line. He needs to be more involved in the offense.
Got them both, did Johnson. And when it felt like Prairie View A&M was pulling away, they look in the rearview mirror and see the Tigers right behind them.
And then you get the turnover. Scott turned that one over, trying to penetrate.
The opportunity to take the lead for TSU. Blanks into the paint.
And that was a walk. Referees missed that one.
Hey, good to Briscoe. Hey, good. Sends it over to Scott after they conversed for a bit.
Wow, illegal screen.
And I think Briscoe's the guy guilty. It is his third. Texas Southern again with an opportunity to claim the lead back.
Prairie View needs a stop.
Gibbs.
He almost threw that one away.
Thomas able to track it down. Back into the corner to Gibbs. Lost into the paint, picked up by Shepherd. Turns around, shoves it to the glass. Got it back, fade away, and there is a whistle and foul.
Shepherd has been a beast on the glass tonight. He's doing an outstanding job. That was his ninth or tenth rebound, because I think he got two on that. But he's been doing a pretty good job on the glass. He shot the ball. He didn't stay there. He went after it again. Then he was able to get the foul. And he hit every part of the rim and was able to get that one to fall.
Four minutes away from a possible overtime game.
Shepherd has 11 rebounds. That was his 12th rebound.
One for two, wow. But it winds up in the hands of Blank. And Blank able to put it in.
Now let's see how Prairie View react after being up for most of the game and now they're trailing by two.
Briscoe hands it to Haygood. Inside four to play. Haygood into the paint. York with a finger roll.
We haven't heard much from Gibbs tonight, so I wouldn't be surprised if down the stretch we hear a little more from him.
Blanks has got it in the left corner. Here's Gibbs playing with 4 points in the game.
It's a good block.
Johnson.
Good block.
His shot blocked as Haygood will take it to the Prairie View end. 51-51. Back over it goes to Haygood with the shot clock into single digits. Down to 7-6-5. Haygood in the paint. It is smashed by Shepherd. Minutes 35 seconds to play. We're tied at 51 all as Shepherd sent it over to Baytown.
Started my Camry, went to the auction, won a storage locker. Found an old guitar. Tracked down the previous owner. Reunited them. Hit the jackpot.
The bold new Camry. One bold choice leads to another. Toyota, let's go places.
Toyota SWAC Basketball Tournament in Houston, Texas. 5 days of nonstop action, and it all goes down March 10th through the 14th. The SWAC is driven by passion and motivated by pride, because in the SWAC, history will be made. We do it for the love of the game. Visit www.swachoops.org.
Fans, don't forget to support the 2015 SWAC Men's and Women's Tennis Tournament. It will be held at City Park Tennis Center in New Orleans, Louisiana. And it happens in April, the 10th through the 12th. And, of course, outdoor track and field happens at Alabama A&M, the Lewis Cruz Stadium, April 24th through 26th. See you there. That's up in your neck of the woods.
Great venue. Brand-new track. Should be great.
Speaking of great, how about the final 2:35 of this one, tied at 51 into Onwukamuche, who's got four personals, missed it, and Blanks has it.
They got the shot that they were looking for. They got a point-blank shot at the basket. Came up a little short.
Thomas looking over Briscoe. Able to get it to Shepherd.
I still think it's Gibbs time. I think it's his time of the game.
He's got 4 points, three assists, both well below his average, especially the points. Blanks, stolen away by Scott, then he walked with it.
But you know what? Coach Rim should be talking about, that was a shot clock violation. That was a shot clock violation.
No buzzer, but.
You got a timeout on the court.
You're thinking the 35 went to zip.
Right.
Timeout on the floor. Taking a look at it again, and you can see the clock at the top of the screen.
Okay, right now, it should be at zero before he walked with the ball.
Excellent point. It was down to one, and as you mentioned, zips before the walk by Scott. Officials didn't see it. Let's take a break on the SWAC Digital Network.
Toyota SWAC Basketball Tournament in Houston, Texas. 5 days of nonstop action, and it all goes down March 10th through the 14th. The SWAC is driven by passion and motivated by pride, because in the SWAC, history will be made. We do it for the love of the game. Visit www.swachoops.org.
Prairie View A&M taking on Texas Southern, and we are tied at 51 each with a minute 56 left to play in this one. Nobody's heading home yet. Nobody's hitting the exit doors.
Oh, no. This one will go down to the wire.
It has been very, very loud here at the H&PE Center on the campus of Texas Southern. And the men of Texas Southern and Prairie View A&M have not disappointed.
Let's see what Coach Davis has worked out here. I'm thinking he's going to have something off the dribble.
Thomas picks up the dribble, top of the key. Got to get rid of it soon, running out of time, and there was a timeout call. Mike Davis knew
right.
that 5 seconds was about to expire. And from the sidelines, asked for the timeout.
Yeah, that's a 30-second timeout. Coach Davis wanted to save the possession. It still was 26 seconds left on the shot clock.
SWAC Digital Network, not only in Pine Bluff, Arkansas on the 16th, and not only in Jackson, Mississippi later this month. SWAC Digital Network is in Birmingham, Alabama, the 21st and 22nd for the Indoor Track and Field Championships of the Birmingham Crossplex. Finals to be broadcast live right here on the SWAC Digital Network. Understand that the color analyst in that one, an Olympic gold medalist. I can just leave it at that. Tease you with the details a little bit later on. Action resumes. Blanks with it. Top of the key. Thomas to the post and then to Shepherd. Shepherd with 11 rebounds, but five away from the double-double. He's got 5 points in the game.
Teardrop.
Gibbs with a miss. Thomas in is rejected by Onwukamuche.
It's a good job by Regis in there to protect the lane.
That was a huge block. If Thomas makes it, then Texas Southern's got the lead. 1 minute to play, tied at 51. York for three.
Big shot, big time shot. And Coach Rim gets a timeout. That's a big time shot from a guy that normally doesn't put up that many threes.
York, 4-3. And Arkansas make that Prairie View A&M leading it by that margin.
Started my Camry, went to the auction, won a storage locker, found an old guitar. Tracked down the previous owner. Reunited them. Hit the jackpot.
The bold new Camry. One bold choice leads to another. Toyota, let's go places.
Robert Williamson, Van Petaway, H&P Arena. Texas Southern, you predicted an OT game. Still thinking overtime?
Well, yeah, it could still happen. But right now, with only 55 seconds to go on the clock, Texas Southern does not have to go for a three. There's plenty of time left in this game. I'm sure Coach Davis has worked something up where they're going to get a quick shot because he can still get the basketball back. And Prairie View is going to just apply enough pressure so that the clock has to start as soon as they get the ball.
And if you shoot the threes, the odds aren't with you today for Texas Southern. They
right.
are 2 of 16.
Right, right. That's why I think they're going to draw up something going to the, well.
And now 2 of 17. Onwukamuche wraps up the rebound. Hey, good foul by Blanks, and there wasn't much else Blanks could do.
Well, from the way Coach Davis is acting, I don't think he was looking for that three-point shot. And that was just a 16 foul.
So really not a bad foul with 39 seconds to play. This is a big possession for the View. And immediately, Haygood is fouled by Thomas. We go to the other end of the floor. Prairie View will shoot the 1-1.
And Haygood's only a 57% free throw shooter, so that's an excellent job.
Big free throws here. You hit the front end, and you make it a two-possession game.
Still a lot of time left in this game, though. You shot that one like you've been shooting 90% from the line.
Onwukamuche with four personals has stepped away from the lane. They don't want him getting a cheap fifth foul.
Well, they need him back here protecting that basket, the rim protector. He's been doing a great job at that tonight. Whoa.
York almost tipped it back in. Gibbs coming down with it. A four-possession game. I'll make that a four-point game, two-possession ball game.
I think Texas Southern got a timeout in all of that.
Two-point ball game, 55-53. 28 seconds left. What do you draw up if you're Mike Davis here?
Well, if you're Mike Davis, you're over there trying to you're talking to your assistant. He's looking at the same sheet that we have here, trying to figure out who are the poor free throw shooters. You want to foul somebody that has not had a good night at the free throw line. And then with Texas Southern, I'm sorry, with Prairie View, there are a couple of guys who will stay away from Hamilton if he's in the game. Everybody else, other than Johnson, you can put him on the free throw line. You take your chances. And on Prairie View side, Coach Rim should be designing something to get the ball in the hands of his best free throw shooter.
You saw there Kareem York, who hit the three that put the margin out to three. 54-51 at the time. And certainly at that point, and with Haygood's follow-up, advantage appeared to belong to Prairie View A&M. But now, a two-point ball game. You found the right guy, and maybe, just maybe, if you were Texas Southern.
But Prairie View still has to get it in. You might, well, they did get it in this time.
And Thomas trying to foul Briscoe and just can't catch up with him. I mean, he's popping the bicep, and he's grabbing him by the hips, and
now
Mike
Coach
Davis
is trying to tell him they fouled over there in the corner. They didn't want all that time to run off the clock.
5 seconds run off the clock as Briscoe goes to the line.
Briscoe is 67% free throw shooter.
Big free throws for Briscoe. And this one becomes even bigger. This turns it into a two-possession game again.
Now it's his first time at the line tonight. This is a big free throw, but still there's enough time on the clock where miss or make, Texas Southern does not have to go for a three.
And it's a miss, not a make. Thomas with it, over to Gibbs. Thomas in the paint, off the glass. Shepard ripping down the rebound. Did he walk or did he get fouled?
He's going to get him a foul. They're going to get Regis for that one.
And if it is on Wukamuche, he's done.
No, they didn't get Regis. 21.
It is Scott that picks up the personal. Shepard of the line, right at a 50-50 free throw shooter.
56%, but he's 4 out of 8 tonight from the line. Big guy hit a clutch free throw, but they need one more.
13 seconds left. Huge free throw here for the grad student. Nick Shepard missed it. Rebound, Texas Southern. Madarius Gibbs for three. Scott winds up out of bounds. Wow. Texas Southern's got it with 5.9 seconds left.
Mike Davis is trying to get a timeout. That was a lot of action. I would like to see that again. I thought it should have been a foul call on that.
Well, if it's a lot of action you want to see again, you know, Mr. James Crenshaw, our executive producer, is your wish is his command.
Great rebound in here. Everybody's fighting for it. I thought Shepard came over the back.
And that's the reason that Scott wound up on the floor.
I thought Shepard came over the back.
5.9 seconds left to play.
Two-point game. Mike is at home. He's going for the win. Overtime would be great for him because his team is in better shape in terms of foul situation. Uh-oh, I've seen this setup before. If you're not careful, we're going to end it. He's going to tie it up on the dunk.
Gibbs from the baseline.
Got the foul on the push.
Thomas on the floor. Thomas at the line, and Thomas with a chance to tie.
Well, they'll get a chance to sing to Reeves.
Onwukumuche is fouled out of the ballgame. And here comes the music. Heard it earlier today when Shamira Brooks fouled out of the ladies' game. And now the house is rocking.
Tell them to go sit down.
The exit of Onwukumuche. Five fouls, he's out of the game. Big free throws for Thomas.
Hey, get that chair out of there, man.
And of course, coach is a little upset because there's a chair.
Yeah, that you hurt. Get one of the players hurt.
Chair that has been put on the floor by the Texas Southern mascot. And now Thomas at the line shooting. Misses his first.
Big miss. Big miss.
Second free throw. Off as well. Saved. Blanks falls. And it wasn't saved. Stepping out.
Prairie View's ball. But now, Prairie View's got to get this ball inbound. They cannot afford a steal. You got to have somebody inbounding this ball that's not afraid.
Riley thought he had saved it. Instead, stepped out. Prairie View will bring it in from the baseline. York's got 5 seconds, and he gets it in to Scott, fouled immediately by Gibbs.
Now Scott is going. Scott has he's a 66% free throw shooter, and on tonight, Mr. Scott has been to the line 2 times, and he has both of them, so he's in a rhythm. So that might be a good sign for Prairie View. But with 4 points, with 4 seconds left in the game, Texas Southern has enough time to get off a good shot.
You make them both, it doesn't matter.
That's true.
You make one of the two, and there's still a chance.
Everybody in the building is on their feet.
Scott makes his first. He has been quiet in the second half. But this would be a really loud free throw. He hits it.
And Prairie View is going to get a timeout. Coach Rim is going to talk to his kids about what to do. And really, with a four-point lead, they don't have to foul anybody. They can let Texas Southern, just don't let them get a direct pass.
That's got to be the bulk of the conversation. Don't foul.
Correct.
If they hit the three, they're still one down. Checking into the lineup, Wesley Offalin. 6'7 junior from Houston, Texas. Got a lot of playing time. when we did the Grambling Prairie View A&M game a couple of weeks back, but limited playing time in this one, but he is inserted into the lineup now.
Well, with the fans coming around the court now, security's going to have to get these officials out of here.
Gibbs to bring it in from the baseline on the other end of the floor. It is a four-point lead for Prairie View.
Oh, Thomas. He stopped. Game over.
Is it over or not? No, officials indicating maybe not. And now the officials will confer.
They're going to call a foul. I think they're going to have a foul with a couple tenths left in the game. See, they've inbounded the ball. The clock's already at zero on here. But I think once they make the pass, here's the foul right here.
And the officials have conferred.
But now, if they're putting tenths or eighth, okay, they can get a tip.
Foul, and you've got the shots coming.
But it's not going to do you any good. You're down by four. You're down by four, so really there's nothing you can do with it.
Collier missing his first. And even if there was something hopeful, you had to make one of the two.
Correct.
Game over, Prairie View A&M wins it. Alabama State is now all alone atop the SWAC.
Right, that was a tough loss for Texas Southern. They wanted to keep pace with Alabama State, and they still got to make that trip to Alabama. So it's a big win for Prairie View, a tough loss for Texas Southern.
This win is over. It's a split of a doubleheader. Ladies win for Texas Southern and the men for Prairie View A&M. We come back to wrap up our coverage in Houston right after this break.
Toyota SWAC Basketball Tournament in Houston, Texas. 5 days of nonstop action, and it all goes down March 10th through the 14th. The SWAC is driven by passion and motivated by pride. Because in the SWAC, history will be made. We do it for the love of the game. Visit www.swachoops.org.
Started my Camry. Went to the auction. Won a storage locker. Found an old guitar. Tracked down the previous owner. Reunited them. Hit the jackpot.
The bold new Camry. One bold choice leads to another. Toyota, let's go places.
Coach, it didn't go to overtime, but it got close. 58-55, the final score. Prairie View A&M, 500 now in the SWAC at 5-5, 7-16 overall. Texas Southern no longer shares that top spot of the conference as they have fallen to number two behind Alabama State. Big loss for Texas Southern, big win for Prairie View.
Big loss for Texas Southern. I thought Prairie View came in here. They worked hard from start to finish. They really pushed Texas Southern to the limit.
What does this do as far as the standings are concerned? I mean, Prairie View now moves maybe a little bit above that mid part of the order.
Right, depending on what the teams did behind them, yes, they are certainly moving up, but I think confidence is the biggest thing that they gained tonight. They came on the road in a hostile environment and won a big ball game, and so I think that's going to do well for Coach Rim and his guys down the stretch.
One of those teams, Prairie View A&M, you never can count out.
Right,
you
right.
Never know when they'll turn on the after jets.
And it's not really over for Texas Southern. It's just going to be difficult. Just that they're going to need some more help now because they still have to make the trip to Montgomery. they can beat Alabama State to go back into a tie with them, but they've got to get their heads right after losing this tough game at home.
Coach, you and I head back to Alabama, but we're in Arkansas on the 16th of February, and that's when Alcorn State will head to the University of Arkansas at Pine Bluff for a big ball game. Looking forward to some exciting ball players in that one.
Yeah, we'll see some great players in that game. You got Mosley for Pine Bluff. You got Luckett, who was preseason player of the year in the SWAC. So there's gonna be a great game, some great players out there.
And be there 16th, a week from Monday, as the SWAC Digital Network makes our way to Pine Bluff University of Arkansas at Pine Bluff as they play host Alcorn. Great working with you again, Coach. Looking forward to the 16th of February when we meet again in Arkansas.
It's been my pleasure, and I love working with you guys. James and the rest of the crew did an outstanding job, and we look forward to kicking it up again at Pine Bluff.
And, of course, you're talking about James Crenshaw, our executive producer. Job well done, James. Thanks for our crew. Buck, Raymond, Rashida, and let's see, JT, all off the top of my head.
That's
great job
good.
On the camera crew. Thank you so much for watching. Van Pettaway's been doing the color on the men's game. Dante Wederma on the ladies' game. Robert Williamson saying so long for the SWAC Digital Network.